Hallelujah. God is so good. God is great. God is amazing. And we thank him every day for waking us up and starting us on our way. Hallelujah. God is so amazing. The things he do for us every day blows my mind. I heard somebody say, Lord, when I go to church, I want to be renewed, revived, and restored. And I pray that for everybody in here, that you leave here either be renewed, revived, or restored. Because that's what he wants for us. That's what he wants for you. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. We love you, Jesus. We honor you today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a lifting of the hand. There's a lifting of the heart, yes there is. There's a lifting of the eyes beyond the hills to where our help comes from. Come on and say, there's a lifting of the hand. Come on and say, there's a lifting of the heart. Come on and say, there's a lifting of the eyes.
There's a lifting of the eyes.
Beyond the hill.
Beyond the hill.
To where help
comes from.
Come on and say, there's a lifting.
There's a lifting of the hand.
Come on and say, there's a lifting of the heart.
There's a lifting of the heart.
There's a lifting of the eyes, say.
There's a lifting.
beyond the hill,
beyond the hill,
to our help
comes from.
Yeah, yeah, our help,
our help comes from you.
Come on and say, our help comes from you.
Our help comes from you.
Come on and say, our help for me.
Our help comes from you.
Beyond
the hill.
To our
help. Our help comes from.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on and say, our help.
Our help comes from you.
Come on and say, our help comes from you.
Our help comes from you.
Hallelujah,
our help comes from you,
beyond the heat,
to our help comes from,
yeah, yeah,
our help comes from you,
we lift up our eyes,
we lift up our hands,
our help comes from you, we lift up our hands. Cause I realize where my help comes from. And I realize where my help comes from. Cause I realize where my help comes from. Say,
I realize
where my help comes from. I realize, say,
I realize
where my help comes from.
I realize, say,
I realize where my help comes from. Hallelujah, Jesus, you are my source. You are my help. You are my healer. That's why I love you so much. Because you loved us first. You loved us first, Jesus. Your love is amazing. Your love is great. Hallelujah, your love is amazing. Hallelujah, yes it is, yes it is. Your love is kind. Your love is patient. You fill my heart with so much peace and joy. See, Jesus, you're amazing. You make my life feel brand new. See, you're amazing. You make my life feel brand new. Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much your excess love, oh.
Jesus, you love me too much, oh. Say,
too yeah. Much, oh. Too much your excess love, oh.
Your love, say,
your love is kind.
Yeah. Say your love is patient.
Your love is patient.
You fill my heart.
You fill my heart
with so much peace.
With so much peace and joy.
Say you're amazing. Say you're amazing.
You're amazing.
You make my life.
You make my life feel brand new.
Say you're amazing. Say
you're amazing.
You make my life.
You make my life feel brand new.
Hey, come on and say, Jesus, you love me too much, oh. Say,
too much, oh. Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Yeah, come on and say, Jesus, you love me too much, oh. Say,
too much, yeah. Oh. Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Come on and say, say, Jesus, you love me too much, oh, say.
Too much, oh,
yeah.
Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Come on and say, Jesus, Jesus, you love me too much, oh, say.
Too much, oh,
too much, oh,
too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Come on and say your love is kind. Say,
your love is kind.
Yeah. Say your love is patient.
Your love is patient.
He fills my heart. Say,
you fill my heart
with so much peace and joy.
With so much peace and joy.
Come on and say, you're amazing.
You're amazing.
You make my life.
You make my life feel brand new.
Come on and say, you're amazing.
You're amazing.
You make my life.
You make my life feel brand new.
Hey, come on and say, Jesus, you love me too much. Oh, say,
too yeah. Much. Oh.
Too much.
Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Come on and say, Jesus, you love me too much, oh, yeah.
Too much,
too much, oh.
Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Yeah, yeah. Come on and say, Jesus, Jesus, you love me too much, oh, yeah.
Too much, oh.
Too much,
too much, oh, excess
he loves
love,
me too
oh.
Much, oh. Come on and say, Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much,
yeah.
Oh, too much, oh, excess love.
Yeah. Hey. Come on and say your love. Come on and say your love.
Your love
is amazing.
Is amazing.
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 Your grace.
Your grace
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 is amazing.
Is amazing.
Your love.
Your love
is amazing. Hey. Your love. Hey.
Is amazing.
Your love.
Your love
is amazing.
Your love.
Your love.
Is amazing.
Is amazing.
You're amazing.
Your grace.
Your love.
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 You're amazing.
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 Hey, you're amazing.
You're amazing.
You're amazing.
You're amazing.
You're amazing.
You're amazing.
Your grace.
You're amazing.
It's amazing.
You're amazing.
Your grace.
Your grace.
It's amazing.
You're amazing.
Your grace.
Your grace.
It's amazing.
It's 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 amazing.
Your love.
Your love.
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 Your love is kind. Say,
your love is kind.
Hey, your love is patient.
Your love is patient.
You fill my heart. Yes, you do, Jesus.
You fill my heart
with so much peace and joy.
With so much peace and joy.
Come on and say, you're amazing.
You're amazing.
Hey, he's amazing. He's amazing. You make my life
feel brand new.
Come on and say you're amazing. Yeah.
You're amazing.
You make my life.
You make my life feel brand new.
Jesus, Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, oh. Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Jesus, you love me too much, oh. Oh.
Too yes, much, you do. Oh, too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Come on and say, Jesus, Jesus, you love me too much, oh. Oh.
Too yeah, yeah. Much, oh, too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, oh. Too much, oh. Excess love, oh.
Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, oh. Too much, oh. Excess love, oh.
Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Oh, how he loves us,
yeah,
oh.
Monica.
Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us, oh. And know how he loves us, oh.
Yeah.
Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us, oh. Come on and say, he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Yeah.
Oh.
He loves us. Oh,
oh, hey.
us so much.
Oh,
he loves us so much. He loves us so much. Oh, how he loves. Come on and say, oh, he loves us.
Hey,
yes, he does.
Oh,
when you think of his goodness and all he's done for you, all you can say is, he loves me. He loves me. He loves me. He loves me. He loves me.
Oh,
yes, he does.
He
died for you and me, just so we could be free. And he'll do it again. And he's done it again. He loves. He loves. He loves. He loves us. Yes, he does.
He loves us.
Hey. He loves us. Yes.
Warner Revivers. This is our Communion Sunday. And if this is your first time visiting for in-person service or on our Facebook Live, Pastor Paul, Lady Shannon, and the RCMI family welcomes you and thank you for joining us today. RCMI family, these are your announcements for the week of November 5th, 2023. The cafe will be open and they will be serving beef lasagna or Alfredo lasagna with or without spinach, salad, and garlic parm rolls for $20. Thanks for your continued support of the cafe. Next Sunday is Baptism Sunday. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and would like to be baptized, please fill out a baptism form located in the fellowship hall and Deacon Dixie will contact you with further instructions. Please join our Wednesday Bible study at 7 p.m. as our ministers and exhorters will be teaching on the topic of thankfulness for the month of November. Don't miss this opportunity to grow in God's Word. There are several ways to give. If you would like to give by Cash App, use the Cash App name $RevCenmin. You can also use your credit cards to swipe, so you do not need to write your numbers on the envelopes. The finance team will be available before and after services to pay your giving using your credit cards. You still can give online as well. And thank you for your continued financial support for the ministry. We leave you with these words to think on. Those blessings are sweetest that are won with prayer and worn with thanks.
To the end, and now
and Omega, beginning and the ending, whatever, whatever you need, all you gotta do is ask for Jehovah Rapha, I'll heal it be. No mountain's too high, no valley's too low, no river too wide. Wherever you go, I'm the God of Jacob, the God of Isaac, the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Communion. Hallelujah. How many of you know he's God? Come on, come on. If you believe that today, we're going to go ahead and get ready for communion at this time. And after communion, we'll dismiss our young people.
Who knows he is God? Hallelujah. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me, for you and me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. The blood came streaming down. The blood came streaming down. The blood came streaming down for me, for you and me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. He's coming back again.
Come on.
He's coming back again. He's coming back again for me, for you and me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me.
How many know it was the blood? Matthew 4:4, as it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word. Can you say every word? That proceeded out of the mouth of God. I am standing for Holy Communion. Colossians 1:14, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the redemption of sins, forgiveness of sins. Hebrews 9:14, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience, cleanse your conscience from dead works to serve, I said, to serve the living God. For as much as you know, you were not redeemed by corruptible things such as silver and gold, but by the precious, and I do emphasize precious blood of Jesus Christ. Can somebody say, I know it was the blood? Well, since you know it was the blood and you have confessed with your mouth and believed in your heart upon the Lord Jesus Christ, and you believe that God has raised Jesus Christ from the dead, then we invite you this morning, this mid-morning, to partake with us in this holy sacrament. Can somebody say amen? 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, starting at the 23rd verse. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, this do in remembrance of me. After the same manner, Jesus also took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread, listen, and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily, shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man or a woman examine him or herself, and so let him or her eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he or she that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to him or herself. Why? Not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause, Paul said, many are weak and sickly among you, and many do sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, Salah, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not, I repeat, should not be condemned with the world. Can somebody say amen to the word of God? Let's ask God's blessing upon these elements, that they may be used for divine purpose. Must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? No, there's a cross for you and there's a cross for me. Father, in the matchless name of Jesus, we pray right now by the power of the Holy Ghost that you will look deep down into the recesses of our heart. And my God, if there be any sin, any iniquity, we pray right now that you will root it out, cast it into the sea of forgiveness as far as the east is from the west. That's eternally, never to be remembered anymore. And we will be careful, so careful, to give you all the glory, all the honor, and total praise now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless. I said faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. You be power, glory, dominion, and majesty to the King eternal, immortal, invisible, to the only wise God. In Jesus' name we pray. We seal this communion prayer. In Jesus' name, let the church, let the congregation say, amen. Amen, amen, amen. You may stand now in honor of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if everyone has been served, we're going to ask that you would take your wafer and let's raise it towards heaven. Jesus said in John 6:51, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. And if any man or any woman should eat of this bread, they shall live forever. Let us eat together. Receive your healing. I said, receive your healing today. That's for somebody today. Hallelujah. Likewise, let us lift our cups towards heaven. Isaiah 53:5. For he was wounded, pierced for your transgressions, bruised, crushed for your iniquities. The chastisement of your peace was upon him. And by his stripes, with his stripes, you are healed. I said you are healed in Jesus' name. Let us commune together. Maranatha, even so come. Amen. Lord Jesus, God bless you.
Oh, you are the living word. Jesus, 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 Jesus. That's what we call you. You know what? I didn't do my welcome today. If this is your first time being here, Revival Center Ministries, we don't want you to say anything, but we do want to at least acknowledge you. Do we have any first-time visitors here today? Raise your hand. First-time visitors? Okay, wonderful. Stand up. So glad to have you here. We want to put something in your hand. Amen. I didn't want to, and those of you who are watching on live, If this is your first time, make sure you let our wonderful Facebook Live family know, and they will give you a warm welcome. So right now we're going to, one thing I want to say, I see all these wonderful young adults out here, young people. It's so good to see that. Let's put our hands together for that. I'm just looking like, wow. So we have our nursery. Our nursery can go ahead and be dismissed. And then we'll have Minister Durrell. He's going to take our young men in the back. Y'all follow Minister Durrell. And then Kanya's going to take our young ladies. Y'all can be dismissed at this time. Everybody else can stand up and greet someone and hug someone at this time as our pastor comes to us at this time. Go ahead and do that.
Go, Pastor. Hold on. Pastor Durrell. Get Pastor Durrell. Kanya, hold your group up real quick. Hold it. Pastor Durrell, this one. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, put your hands together and give God some praise. Before everybody leave out, I want to do something. This past, I believe it was Thursday, November the 2nd, Elder Sharon's birthday. Come on, we can do better than that. And she sings to us all the time. So we're going to sing to her happy birthday. But before we do that, come on, Monica. I want you to present. We got a presentation.
So, not yet, Corey. But when it comes around, I'll let you know. So anybody that's in the worship and arts, come on up. We want everybody that's in worship and arts, flag, mime, praise team, dance team, drill team, jazz team, I don't know, all the teams. We're going to honor Elder Sharon. We call her the great elder for her birthday. And I know some of y'all be like, well, y'all didn't honor me for my birthday. Shutting it down right now. Y'all not here at 8 a.m. when other people ain't here. Y'all not here setting up the tables, hanging up banisters. Every time you see a new banister, that's Sharon. Every time you, the back in the back, that's Elder Sharon. I came last Saturday. She was getting ready for the harvesting. I said, what are you doing? She said, I need pumpkins. I said, you don't need pumpkins. Sharon does so much for the ministry, not just for the ministry, for the community, for the city of Dayton. Elder Sharon is a gift to the city of Dayton. And I'm telling you, I act crazy sometimes, but I tell you, my sister Sharon, everybody should have a sister like Sharon, I'm telling you. Between my sister Sharon and my sister Miracle, I just thank God that he gave us Elder Sharon because she does so much. Even when I had my stroke, y'all, sometimes it just chokes me up. But she said she stood over my body and said, I will not cry until he brings you back. That's the type of people that you need in your life who will not give up on you and trust God that he will bring you back. That's the type of sister that she is. She stands in the gap for my brother Paul. She stands in the gap for our whole family, and she doesn't get recognized like she should. But I'm telling you, she entrusted me with Westwood. She's doing things that makes me want to be a better person. If I could be just a little part of Sharon, just a little part. I mean, she does get on my nerves when we go on trips, and she praying at 5 in the morning. I'm like, even vacation, you praying in the bathroom at 5 in the morning? But that's what type Sharon is, steadfast, unmovable, always. I'm telling you, we always make a joke. God, Jesus on the right hand, Sharon on the left. You don't know nobody else who got the Holy Ghost at 5 years old. The Holy Ghost with the utterance of tongues, saints. And I just want to honor her today. And everybody just wanted to say, happy birthday to you, Sharon. You don't like being acknowledged because she hates the limelight, but today we're going to honor you. Today you need to know how amazing you are to this church, to this ministry, to the city of Dayton, Sharon Conyers. It is your birthday, and we love you. And I know mom and dad, I mean, she is the best example of both of my parents. Holiness is still right, and she is like my mom. Wherever she goes, she's the boss. She walks around Westwood, and the teachers run to her like, what are we going to do? I'm not lying, y'all. The principal walking by, and they look at her like, Miss Sarah, Miss Conyers, I'm serious. Everywhere she goes, she just carries leadership and authority, and that's the kingdom of God. If you want to watch the kingdom of God, Sharon lives right, and God is pleased with you, Sharon. I know he is. That's why anything that you desire, Sharon gets. Anything Sharon asks for, God gives it to her because he can trust her, because he loves her. She is a real child of God. And I know my brother Paul, he loves her. He just, same thing I'm saying, everybody in my family feels the same way. And I'm just telling you, we're going to honor you today and for the rest of your life, because you're going in the rapture, sis. You're going in the rapture. You won't leave before the rapture. And he might send you back down to one of the two witnesses. I don't know. She might be back with two witnesses, but she's going up, saints. So we're going to sing happy birthday to Elder Sharon. Yes. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Elder Sharon. Sopranos, altos. Happy. Yes. Yes. To you. Yeah. Oh, Carol.
Okay, so I was asked to do the presentation for on behalf of the choir, and what God gave me to say is just falling in line with everything you just said. The words that the Holy Spirit gave to me were consistently committed. And I don't know if you know, I don't know if any of y'all know what a gift that is. It's a lot of people that will commit to things, and they'll start but not finish. And everything that I've seen you put your hands to do since I've been here, and I know a lot of people have known you a lot longer than I have, you start it and you finish it. And even what you're doing in the community right now with the children, that is such a blessing because it's so needed with this generation. And so the Bible has a scripture that says what you do in secret, God will reward you in the open. And he also gave me, you don't do stuff for fame and fortune, for notoriety, for accolades, for limelight. You do it because it's your heart and it's your passion. And anybody, sis, who is connected to you, anybody who knows you, anybody who's been in your presence, anybody who has even talked to you, can see the open reward on your life by the hand of God. So on behalf of the choir, as the saying goes, we can't pay you for what you do. But from our hearts and with love, we give you this. I pray that it be a blessing to you, and we thank God for you. We love you.
Y'all can be seated. Thank you. Come on, give God a praise. Do we have Sharon's Cash App? Monica, you spoke well. You spoke well, everything you said. We got her Cash App. Put her Cash App on the screen. I want to give you an opportunity to those of you who want to sow into her life. I want to give you an opportunity to do that. So if we got his Cash App, put her Cash App on the screen.
Derek is S Conyers, Conyers. And it takes up to $5,000. So if you want to Cash App, fives, four, three, two, and one.
You want it? Yeah, come on, bring it up. Just, okay. Just say it on the altar. Yeah. going to get ready to give, we want to give. You can still Cash App Elder Sharon when you put the Cash App up. But I want to take this opportunity to give. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. Raise your hand high. Put your hands up. Let them know you need an envelope. Put your hands up. It's time for us to honor our Father. If I be your Father, where is my honor? And we want to honor the Lord today. Keep your hand up. Keep your hand up. Don't put them down. They're coming. Yeah. Kanye's class. Everybody's in Kanye's class. You can be dismissed. She's waiting on you. Yeah, dismiss yourself. Keep your hand up if you need an envelope. Those of you that's watching us by Facebook Live, you know what to do. Thank you for your gift. Thank you for what you do. We appreciate your offering. It takes money to do ministry, and so you make it possible. Every one of you here make it possible for us to do effective ministry. We don't have to pull our hair out because we come short, but you make it possible for us to meet every need that we have in this ministry because of your giving. Keep your hand up if you need an envelope. Elder Sharon is truly a gift to this house. We love her. We can't, Monica said a mouthful, but we can't say enough about her. She is a tremendous woman of God, and we thank God for her. So make sure you stop her and put something in her hand when you see her. Don't hesitate. Do something. Do something for her. Stand on your feet with your offering. Everybody standing. Father, we thank you for the seed we're about to sow. We don't give grudge or necessity, but we know you love a cheerful giver. Now minister the seed to the sower. Increase the fruits of our righteousness, and we'll forever give you glory and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen. Remain standing. They're going to send you around. Remain standing.
Oh.
calls me friend.
He calls
me friend. He calls me friend. He calls me friend.
And got so comfortable singing, he leaned over the pool. I said, that's a move right there. He leans over it. That's awesome. You may be seated. Thank you for joining us. Those of you who join us by Facebook Live, we wave at you. Glad you're with us. I'm not really going to be long. I just want to exhort you real quick because I believe this message is important for us to hear. I want to continue to thank everyone for their prayers for me and my family, and just you're so important to me through this time of tribulation and trials. I thank God that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers out of them all. I said he's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we're able to ask or think. He is a healer. How many of y'all believe God is a healer? How many of you believe, has he healed anybody's body in here? Has he healed anybody's mind in here? If God ever did anything for you, won't you give him a praise? If he's done anything for you, come on, put your hands together. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. He's been better to me than I could ever be to myself. And I'm thankful. Acts 7. I want you to turn to Acts 7. Acts 7. Look at verse 36, I believe I want to go. Acts 7:36. Go down to verse 37. I gotta wait on that. Y'all my only Bible. How y'all end up in Deuteronomy? Acts 7. There, man of God. Look at verse 36. He brought them out after that he had showed wonders and signs in the land of Egypt, and in the Red Sea, and in the wilderness 40 years. This is that Moses was sent unto the children of Israel, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up in your brother like unto me. Him shall you hear him. Look at verse 38. This is he that was in the what? Church where? This is he that was in the church in the wilderness with the angel who spoke to him in the Mount Sinai and with our fathers who received the lively oracles to give us, unto us. I want you to look at verse 38 again. This is he that was in the what? Church in the wilderness. I want you to say that with me. Say church in the wilderness. Church in the wilderness. Say it again. The church, look at me when I say this. The church is in the wilderness. There's, let's break it down. There's Egypt here. There's the wilderness here. And then what's over here? Say the promised land. Egypt, the wilderness, and the promised land. But the church is where? Not in Egypt. The church is not in the promised land. The church is in the wilderness. So if you understand that the church is in the wilderness, you understand that there's more to God than church. There's more to God than going to church. Let me say something. Look at me when I say it. Church is not the final destination. The promised land is. The promised land is the final, not church. Church is in the wilderness. And that's not the final destination. The final destination is the promised land. When God delivered us out of Egypt, he delivered us out of Egypt not to send us to church, but to send us through church. I want you to get that. He didn't save me to put me in church and to sit around for 100 years doing nothing. I wasn't born to go to church. I was born to go through church. Because the church is not the promise. The church, all this we're doing here is not the promise. The promise is the promised land. And so if you understand that, you understand that God has something more for your life. I want you to say there's more for me. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, there's more for you. Come on, say, God has a plan for your life. And it's more than what you ever experienced in church. God saved you to bless you. God saved you to bless you. Somebody shout, I want my inheritance. Lift your hands. I want you to lift your hands. I want you to say, I want my inheritance. There's more to God than what you have ever experienced. What God has for you, your eye have not seen, nor your ear heard, neither have entered into the hearts of man the things that God has prepared for them to love. In other words, God has so much more for you. Now, I said right now, he has so much more for you. He want to give you things you never had. He want to take you places you've never been. In other words, there's a promise waiting for your life. And if you believe it, say, I want my mountain now. I want my mountain right now. Give me my mountain right now. Give me my mountain right now. I want everything. Listen, I want everything God has for me and my family. I want it now. Because the church is in the wilderness. Watch this. The promised land is where I'm going to end up at. That's where I'm going to end up at. Watch this. The church is the process and preparation for the promise. Can I say it again? The church is the process and preparation for the promise. Deuteronomy 8. Go turn to Deuteronomy 8. I don't go to church. I go through church. And going through church is my training ground. This is the place I learn. But this is the place I'm preparing to go to my next level, which is the promise. The promised land is my destination, and I'm going to get there. Deuteronomy 8, is that on the screen? What? Can we get 8? Can you give my sound team a hand as they work through this? Well, this is what it's trying to say. This is what it's trying to say. I took it. Verse 1. 8:1. The devil don't want this message to get out. I took you through the wilderness to do what? To humble you. Watch it. Look up here. I took you through the wilderness to humble you. You are in the church to prepare you and process you for your next level, which is the promised land, which is your final destination. I'm going through church to get to my promised land, but it's preparation. Say preparation. So he said, I'm taking you through the promised land. Let me make something clear to you. The church is not the place you're supposed to perish. This is not the place you're supposed to die. They spent 40 years in the wilderness and they perished. They never made it to their promise because they didn't understand that the church was only a place you're going through, not to. I'm not supposed to live and die in the wilderness. I have greater purpose and plan. God has greater purpose and plan for my life. How many believe he got greater purpose and plan for your life? I want you to look at Hebrews chapter number 4. I want you to understand, I mean, God has big things for us. And I want everything that God has for my life. I'm excited about it. I mean, this is what he wants you to have. He wants you to have everything that Christ died for you to have. But it's in the promise. Say it's in the promise. Hebrews 4, verse 1. Oh, yeah, it's up there. I knew I could count on y'all. Everybody read this with me. Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left of us of entering into his what? That any of you should do what? Don't come short of entering into that promise. There are so many people that died in the wilderness. They never made it to the promise. But I speak for everybody. Just give me one person on every road to just praise God for everybody on your road. We all going in. We all, come on. Come on, tell your neighbor, we all going in. It's called rest. It's called rest. We got to enter into his rest. Church ain't rest, church is work. Church is labor. It's a lot of hard work to go into church, but he said, I want you to labor to enter into my rest. Say my rest. Look at verse 9. Go down to verse 8. Hebrews 4:8. Yeah, there we go. For if Jesus had given them rest, then would he not afterwards have spoken of another day? What's the next verse? Verse 9. Therefore, I want y'all to get this. Therefore, there remaineth a rest for the people of God. There's a day waiting on you called rest. Oh, man, how many of y'all receive that? I want that for your life. It's a day. It's bigger than church. It's bigger than what you've ever experienced in the kingdom. There's so much more to God. But he said there's a day remaining for you. There's a day called rest. And I just got to get through the wilderness. I got to get to the wilderness. There's 5 things I want to say, and then I'm done. I want 5 points I want you to get. All I want you to get is you got to make it into the promised land. You got to get your promise. Christ died for you to have your promise. And there's so much more in the promise than what there was in the wilderness. Watch this. God don't want you to spend 40 years in church and you miss your promise. They spent 40 years in the wilderness and died there and had nothing to show for it. Watch it. There's 5 things I want you to realize. If you complaining, you still in church. Because all they did in the wilderness was murmur, grumble, and complain. There's a lot of complainers in church. A lot of people murmur about what goes on in church. That lets me know you still in the wilderness. Point 2. If you always want to go back to Egypt, you still in the wilderness. Because all they did in the wilderness was wanting to go back. You may not go back physically, but you go back in your mind. Soon as you leave church, you back in the back in Egypt. But you gotta you gotta say, I gotta get to my promise. Because when you get into your promise, you ain't gonna never want to go back to Egypt. That only happens when you're in the church in the wilderness. Number three, if you still eating manna, you in church. Because the manna shut off when they went into the promised land. God shut the manna down. Number four, if you broke, you still in church. Let me show you something. God don't want you broke. Poverty is of the curse. He wants you to be wealthy. That's why the promised land is called the wealthy place. He led me through the fire. He led me through the flood. He brought me into my wealthy place. And that's your wealthy place. But you want to, I mean, I've been in church 40 years and been broke for 40 years. Because you're not in your promise. Deuteronomy 8. Go to 14. The promise, that's what the Lord told me to tell you. The promise is for you right now. He wants you to have it right now for you, right now. Deuteronomy 8:14. Your heart be lifted up and you forget the Lord thy God which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. Next verse. Who led thee through these great, the great and terrible what? Which were fiery serpents, that's bill collectors. Scorpions, that's debt. And drought, that's your water getting cut out. There is no water who brought thee forth water out of the rock of flint. Watch the next verse. Because when you're in the wilderness, you broke. Who fed thee in the wilderness with manna which thy fathers knew not, that he may humble you and that he may prove you to do you good at your latter end. Is that what he said? Yeah. And thou say in your heart, my power, my hand have got me this wealth. Watch what he said. Next verse, last verse. One. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. How many of y'all want your wealth? How many of y'all... First of all, do any of y'all believe y'all wealthy? Do you believe that God has wealth for you? It was his plan. It was in his mind when he said, it's me that give you, it's me, God said, it's me that give you power to get what? I want you to tell three people, I want you to tell three people and say, God wants you to be wealthy. Thank you. Thank you, Abram. Thank you. Now look at them. Did they get it? Did they get it? It is he that gives you power to get wealth. Look at me. But he's talking about the promised land. He's not talking about the wilderness. Wealth is a mentality. It's not things, it's a mentality. It's not stuff, it's the mentality. Because he's dealing with people that's been in slavery for over 400 years. So he got to change. Why you think black people still have a problem? We were slaves over 200 some years in this country. And now you got to penetrate our mindset. Because we've been slaves. We need help. We need to change our stinking thinking. We need to change the way we think. We are in bad shape. So, I mean, if you want to do anything for a black person, change his mind. Don't put a bunch of money in their hands. Because they ain't going to do nothing but blow it. It's going to be gone within 2 months. change the way they think so they can make money on top of money, on top of money, on top of money. They can invest it and bring increase. God wants you wealthy. I hate poverty. I just can't stand poverty. Poverty is from hell. And wherever there's poverty, there's crime. So complaining back to Egypt, still eating manna, broke. And finally, my last point is repetition. You've been around that same mountain too long. You've been at that. That's what he told them when they was in the wilderness. He said, y'all been around that same mountain too long. Repetitious. All you do is come to church on Sunday. It's repetition. This stuff we're doing is repetition. But what's happening? What's really happening? Is there anybody changing? Is there anybody's lives being helped? Are we changing our minds? Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? I want y'all to get this. There's more to God than church. There's a promised land, which is our destination. And he gave it to us by promise. So repetition, we got to get this out of the way. We got to get this complaining out of the way. Back to Egypt out of the way. Still eating manna, broke, so we can enter into the promise God has. And when Caleb got into the promise, you know what he said? He said, give me my mountain. I've been in the wilderness 40 years. I've been in church serving faithfully for 40 years. Give me my mountain. Because everybody, listen to me, everybody here got a wealthy place. I have something even bigger for me than outside this ministry. Watch it. I want you to understand this. This is my mom and dad's legacy. This is not my legacy. I serve their legacy. I continue their legacy, but this ain't my legacy. This is their legacy. I have my own legacy. Thank you for the three hand clap. That's true. I ain't saying that to get a hand clap. I just want you to know you got your own legacy. Your legacy is not my legacy. Your legacy, you got your own, and you should want your legacy. So when they speak about my mom and dad in this church, that's what they supposed to do, because this is their legacy. If this is my legacy, it'd be a different story. But it's not mine. It's theirs. I'm a part of their legacy. But you got to understand that God has a wealthy place for you, too. Not to sit up in somebody's church and serve their church for 40 years and die in their church and never fulfill your purpose. You got a purpose, too. Somebody sent me a text, they said, if you want me to come back and serve back in the ministry, I'll come back. I said, no, you stay where you are. You right where God wants you. Out of Dayton. Don't come back here. There's so much more for you where you at. Are y'all getting this? I just want you to know you got a promised land. You have a wealthy place. And I want to finally say this last scripture I want to go to, because if I keep adding on scriptures, I'll be here for a long time. But this is the meat of it all. I sound like to say this. If you don't make it in to your promised land and you die in your wilderness and you come short and you don't enter into that rest, I ain't talking about heaven. That rest ain't heaven. You can have rest on earth now. Get out of that churchy mentality. Because everybody want to go to church because they don't like being in the wilderness. I want to go too if I'm broke all the time. Yeah, I want to go too if I owe everybody in the world. If I'm up to debt, I'm drowning in debt, I want to go too to heaven. So I don't have to pay no more bills. People that don't want to go, don't want to die are the rich people because they got money to spend. broke people be wanting to go to heaven quickly. The devil's like, I want my sweet now and now. Because if it was heaven, he would have took the children of Israel out of Egypt to heaven. He didn't. He took them out of Egypt to the promise. He had a plan. Watch. He said, watch this. He said, I got a plan for y'all. I'm going to bring y'all out of slavery, and I'm going to make y'all wealthy. I'm going to take you out of slavery and make you wealthy. And he did that. But guess what? But a whole generation didn't go in. Deuteronomy 1. I got good godly news for you. Your children gonna make it in. I don't know if you got that. Give your neighbor a high five and say, your children gonna make it in. Now I know we crying the blues over social media, and social media is something special. But you gotta be smart to really do this stuff these kids are doing. These kids are smart. They smart and they dumb at the same time. But I mean technology, the stuff they be doing, I'd be like, how y'all? Because they want more. They sick of going to church. They sick of being broke. They want more. So God said, Deuteronomy 1:38, look at 38. But Joshua the son of Nun, that's right, was standing before thee. He shall go in thither, encourage him, for he shall cause Israel to inherit it. In other words, Joshua going in. Yay, Joshua. Moreover, your little ones, which you said should be a prey, and your children, which is in that day, had no knowledge between good and evil, they shall go in thither. And unto them will I give it, and they shall possess it. My babies are going to possess it. My children are going to possess the land. That's good news. That's good news. I want everybody here, give God praise for your children. I want you to put those hands together. Put those hands together. Rah, 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 rah. Come on, shout for your children. Cheer. Yeah, rah, 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 rah. This is for my children and my children's children. And my children's children. Come on, rah, rah, rah. Let me hear you. Yeah, let's cheer them on as they walk into the promise. Let's cheer them on as they inherit everything God. They're going to inherit everything God has for them. They're going to see it. And watch this. And it's a land flowing with milk and honey. A land where there's no lack. Man, I want to read this, but I'm not. There's a land that there's no lack. Our kids are going to have more than what we've ever had. Our kids are going to do more than what we've ever done. They're going to go to more places than we've ever been. I'm saying your kids and my kids. Because they're going to realize, church is in the wilderness. And if I stay in church for 40-something years, I'm going to come short of my promise. Galatians 3:18. Did y'all get something this morning? How many of y'all ready for your promise? Because the church is where? I'm not supposed to go to church. I'm supposed to go through church. What did I say? Galatians 3:18. You got that one? For if the inheritance be of the law, it is no more promised. But God gave it to Abraham by what? That's why it's called a promised land. You didn't get it by law. You got it by promise. So the law can't hinder you from reaching your promise. That's good stuff. I'm gonna stop there and pray. I'm gonna stop right there and pray. I can hang my hat right there. Father, I thank you. We didn't shout, we didn't run, we didn't scream because we're tired of just doing church in the wilderness. We running and we broke, busted, and disgusted. We sick in our bodies, depressed in our souls. We want the promise. You promise us healing. You promise us miracles. You promise us breakthrough. And we can't get that by being in the church in the wilderness. I don't want to attend no more church in the wilderness. I want to mature. I want to grow up. I want preparation for my promise. Preparation for my promise. So right now, I honor you, and I thank you for giving me a promised land. It's mine. Everybody here had their own promised land. Everybody here got their own inheritance. But I thank you for what you've done for me and what you're going to do. So I give you glory and praise, for you are special. You are precious. You are awesome. You are wonderful. You are magnificent. And I give you glory and praise in Jesus' name. Put your hands together. Give God some praise. Come on. Everybody watching us at home, give God some praise. Put your hands together. I want to open the altar right now for anybody who wants prayer. You want somebody to lay hands on you? You're sick in your body. You want to give your life to Jesus? The altar workers are on their way. They're making their way up front. If you don't know Christ as your Lord and Savior, you need to make him known. You need to get to know him. He has forgiven you of all your sins. He will write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Is there anyone watching us by Facebook? If you sitting there, wherever you're at home, and you're watching this, you don't know Christ the Lord, and say, put in the comment section, give us your phone number, we'll call you. Whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. God has a promise for you. It's greater than church. There's more to God than church. It's not just Egypt. It's not just the wilderness. There is a promise, a day of rest that remains for the people of God. And I believe we're going to enter that rest. Our children are going to see it. Father, right now, we just once again give everyone to you. Not by might, nor by power, but by your Spirit. I thank you that we're leaning on the arm of Christ. We're living in your strength. I give you glory and praise. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Well, y'all can stand. We can go home. Stand up. Did we ever put Elder Sharon's Cash App up? Did it? Was it up? Okay. If you see Elder Sharon, you want to be a blessing to her, just sow a seed into her life. I want to encourage you to do that. Did you get something this mid-morning? Tired of the same old, same old. Good to see you, Nephi. Love you. Love you. I'm tired of the same old, same old. I know there's more. And we're going to have it in Jesus' name. Lord, watch over us as we leave this place, but not your presence. Be with us until we see each other again. In Jesus' name, amen.